We finally did it. The Godot Development Fund has reached a milestone that will make history, €50,000 per month. While Unity grapples with declining reputation and credibility, a growing number of developers are migrating to Godot, with various studios also contemplating the switch for their upcoming ventures. Let's rewind to September 12th for a moment, when two significant events took place. Unity unveiled a controversial pricing model that would charge developers 20 cents after reaching a certain install threshold. On the same day, Godot publicly announced the Godot Development Fund via blog post, outlining a new way to financially support their platform. The aim of this new funding model is straightforward: eliminate intermediaries so that every dollar or euro contributed goes directly into the engine's development, bypassing any commission fees usually taken by third-party donation platforms like Patreon. This is undoubtedly encouraging news, made even more significant by Unity's stumbling, which has led to a significant migration of developers towards alternatives like Godot. The timing couldn't be better for the Godot team, who had set an ambitious monthly funding target of €50,000. To put this into context, on September 12th, they were garnering around €25,000 a month, meaning that their objective was to double their financial support. Certainly an ambitious goal. Fast forward to today, and while Unity is working back on its unpopular pricing adjustments, the Godot Development Fund has already met its ambitious target, reaching €50,000 in less than 2 weeks. The question that now arises is, what's next? Based on what I've seen, the aim is to bring on board 2 full-time contributors. Some people may argue that doubling the funding should lead to doubling the team size, but that's a misconception. It's crucial to remember that even though Godot operates as a non-profit, its financial planning follows the same principles as any business. The first priority is to ensure the sustainability of ongoing expenses, including salaries for existing team members, in the short to medium term. Mistakes in this sort of financial planning could set the organization back rather than propel it forward. So, I see it as totally normal that their objective now is to go little by little, with small but solid steps. In any case, this wasn't a video I initially intended to make, but I felt compelled to create it due to the sheer excitement of witnessing the tremendous growth of the project I've been following for so long. I'm curious to hear your thoughts on which aspects of Godot should be prioritized moving forward. What features or improvements do you find most necessary? My own hopes are less in the introduction of brand new features and more in solidifying what Godot 4 has already brought to the table. I'm particularly interested in seeing the incorporation of Jolt for a more robust physics engine in Godot 4, as well as better C# support across all platforms. Another development that piques my interest is the forthcoming asset store, which might become not just a marketplace for high-quality assets, but also a full-fledged e-commerce platform where creators can monetize their work. If I understood it correctly, Godot will charge a small commission from each purchase that will go toward funding the engine, which will be yet another way to contribute to the project. That's it for today's short video. Share your thoughts in the comments regarding what features you think should be at the forefront of Godot's development. If you haven't yet and can't afford to, there's a link to the Godot Development Fund should you wish to contribute and help further enhance this engine. Thanks for sticking around till the end of the video. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.